following is an extended product spotlight paid for by BASF Canada and InVigor Hybrid Canola.
Hey everyone, I'm Sean Haney, host of Real Ag Radio, Rural Radio 147, Sirius XM, and founder of Real Agriculture. Hey, thanks for listening and welcome to the next episode of the Canola Podcast, sponsored by InVigor Hybrid Canola from BASF. The Canola Podcast is a series where we dive deep and discuss useful tips and tools growers can take to the field to help grow successful crops. Don't forget to visit canolaschool.com to see agronomic videos from Real Agriculture and BASF throughout the growing season as well. Today we're talking about the demonstration strip trial program that BASF has for InVigor. We'll take you through what the trial program looks like and hear also from a grower about their experiences with the program. All this is going to help you make more informed decisions when selecting InVigor canola hybrids for your farm. I'm joined today by Sheldon Taves. He's part of the technical service team at BASF, and John Badry, who is a grower from Central Alberta near Forestburg. Hey, John and Sheldon, welcome. Great to chat with you.
Thanks for having us, Sean.
Great stuff. Okay, hey, John, give us a brief overview of your farm, the history of it, and tell us a little bit more about it.
For sure. I'm a fourth-generation farmer. I currently farm about 4 miles away from where my great-grandparents homesteaded. A little history of my farm right now is about 11 years ago, my dad and I built a new farm site here. My parents have since retired off the farm, and now me and my wife and our three young boys operate the farm along with some hired help. And we're currently growing wheat, malt barley, canola, and you're going to try some fava beans this year.
Oh, what pushed you to do that?
I was looking for something, I was looking for another crop that would get us a 4-year rotation, and then also something I could seed earlier than wheat, and something that would stand a little better than peas, and so I figured fava beans might be a good fit.
Yeah, sounds good. Well, I'm interested to hear how that works out this season. Hey, Sheldon, give us a brief overview of how long you've been with the BASF Technical Services team and a little bit about some of your background.
So I started into the tech services role in 2015. Been with BASF since 2018 when they took over the InVigor franchise. Grew up southern Manitoba. My wife and I have a small farm in central Alberta, and the technical services team, we work with growers, farmers throughout Western Canada, and there's 14 people that sit on the technical services team that do the trials, and we work with growers on the InVigor trials. We also do fungicide trials, and we do pre-seed herbicides. And we also provide technical transfer of information between our research commercial development group and our sales team, and then as well to retail that we work with. So I recently took a new role within the tech services team. I am now the regional technical services manager, so I'll be managing some of the tech service specialists across Western Canada. So,
great stuff. So we're talking today about the demonstration strip trial program, or DST for short. Sheldon, can you walk us through the DST program and what it all encompasses?
You bet, Sean. If you look at our cycle, the way we work, we start our planning in the fall after all the trials have been harvested. We start meeting with marketing and looking at kind of who our main competitors are in the canola landscape, and talking with our local sales regions as well, so that we have local information as to who we want to compare our InVigor hybrids against. So once we've made some of those decisions, Some years we have new hybrids that we're going to launch, and we find that out usually in February. And then as we come into the springtime, we start looking for cooperators to work with. As I said, there's 14 tech service specialists across Western Canada. So we do about 100 replicated trials. And across the West, each local tech service specialist is going to work with their local sales region to decide where the best place to put those trials are. And so we look for key growers like John to work with. As I mentioned, all of our trials are replicated, and I'll talk a little bit more later on as to why that's important. But working with cooperators, growers like John, they do the seeding, spraying, and harvest of the trials for us, and we help manage those trials. So each strip is the width of the grower's drill, and then we seed usually about 600 feet. And at harvest time, they combine a full header width down the center of each strip. So in the fall after harvest, we take those samples and we go get them graded either at a lab or at a local grain elevator for moisture, dock age, and green seed.
So, John, how long have you been doing these trials with Sheldon?
This is going to be my third year doing the BASF trials.
Okay, so there's some longevity there. So what prompted you to have trials and work with BASF on the DST program?
I wanted the opportunity to see which hybrids were going to do the best in on our soil. And I also wanted to, you know, gain the knowledge and have the support from Sheldon and his team on how we can grow the best canola crops we can.
Yeah, I'm sure that throughout the growing season, having that support, you're always picking up through some of the discussions, some learnings to apply outside of the trial program on an annual basis.
Oh, for sure. The last couple of years of working with them, I've learned lots. So it's always nice to have.
So after everything is harvested, what happens with the results, Sheldon?
So after harvest, like I said, we take and we go get those samples from each strip graded. And because we replicate our trials, we're able to do statistical analysis on those trials to make sure that it's the genetic potential of each hybrid that is giving us the yield that we're seeing. We make sure that when we seed the trials, we make sure that they're seeded in as most uniform area of the field as possible. And because we want everything to be as fair as possible and just show that genetic diversity between the different hybrids. Usually what I've done in the past is I've always taken the gross results and shown them to the grower in the field, had a discussion with them in the field to make sure that they're comfortable with the trial results to make sure that it was a fair trial. Right. If we see if we saw some anomalies in the field, we want to make sure that we either remove that strip out of the trial or just have an understanding as to what may have happened. And we take all those all the yield data and we post it to InVigorResults.ca for other growers to go review that. On InVigor results, each tech service specialist will provide some agronomist comments. Last year, we had about 60 locations where we had weather stations. So we ended up posting the weather data. So looking at high and low temperature each day, and then as well, any moisture events that would have happened. We're going to continue with that. We feel it's good information. Gives growers a little bit more of an insight as to what may have happened at that location when you think about the different weather that can happen.
So, John, if you think back to the time in this 3 years we've been doing these trials, how have the results or your experience influenced the hybrid you may try in future years? Do you have any examples of that, or what's been your experience?
Yeah, for sure. I'd say, you know, 4 years ago, before I was doing these trials, I wasn't growing any pod shatter varieties. I was growing club root varieties, but that was about all. And then the first year of doing the trials is really when I started with the growing some pod shatter varieties. And you know, now I don't grow any varieties that aren't a pod shatter variety. And I think for me, you know, getting to see firsthand which varieties yield better, stand better, and combine easier, you know, makes the decision a lot easier for next year on what to grow.
Yeah. It definitely gives you the greater confidence in making that decision, right?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, because some varieties will do better in one area compared to another. So getting the chance to grow all the different varieties side by side in these trials and the competitors' varieties, you know, it makes it easy to decide what to grow on our land.
Makes a lot of sense. Hey, big thanks to both Sheldon and John for joining us here today to discuss the demonstration strip trial program, DST, and how they can help in selecting high-performing InVigor canola hybrids for your farm, no matter where you are in Western Canada. Thanks for listening, and don't forget to visit canolaschool.com to check out all the great videos, timely videos, throughout the growing season from Real Agriculture and BASF. It really provides everything you need to know about growing canola. Have a great rest of your day, everybody. Cheers.